Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're all doing fine. So welcome to another episode. In today's video, we're gonna analyze, as usual, the Bitcoin price. We're also gonna have a look into Ethereum, and at the end also into the DXY and Nasdaq. And in today's video, I want to focus on these purple lines that you can see here on my chart that I have drawn since many weeks already. And we're gonna recap why I have drawn these purple lines and why they will be very significant here, since we are approaching now this first purple line. And this has to do with the stock to flow model price levels, and that's why we're gonna have a look again on that, because it has been now already many weeks ago since I did that video, and I think a lot of you forgot about what those lines here mean. So we're gonna recap that, and then of course also here in the Bitcoin price you can see that the P cycle top indicator is flashing to sell right now. And if you want to know why I'm not taking profits yet, and I think that this signal here is a bit too early, and in my opinion it's not worth to take out some profits yet because we could about to go really parabolic here to the upside, then make sure that you have watched my video that I uploaded yesterday. If not, then go and watch it. It will also pop up at the end of this video, so make sure that you have watched this. I know it's a bit long, but it's worth to watch it. And now here in the daily time frame, let's go to a more cleaner chart. We can open up here the index chart and zoom out a little bit. So this indicator was made after the old all-time highs that we had so far in our last cycles, and this is now the first time that we are trying to trade with this indicator. And sometimes it signaled exactly the top, sometimes it was a bit too early. We had afterwards maybe even a 100% pump in the price. But usually when this signal is flashing, something is about to happen, and that's why I think we are about to go here completely parabolic to the upside if we are able to break out from this ascending triangle here. But there is also high chance that afterwards, after the next big pump, we could maybe get a correction down to important supports like the 20 weekly moving average, maybe even the 200 daily moving average. So something will happen for sure. And here again you can see what happened here in the past with this indicator. Here in 2017 it signaled exactly the top, and if we go a bit back in time here also in 2013 it signaled perfectly here the cycle top. But remember that this indicator was made after this cycle top, so this is really now the first time that we are seeing this signal flashing with real-time data. And every time this signal was flashing, we came back down to the 200 weekly moving average. Only here in the 2013 local top that we had before we went completely parabolic, we only retraced back down to the 20 weekly moving average. And I think this is also what can happen right now if we are really getting here a local top at around 62, maybe even 70k, and then correct down towards the 20 weekly moving average that currently is here at around 44k. So you can see that this moving average is coming very fast higher, and that's why I told you that in my opinion it's not worth really to take your profits at 60k and then hope to rebuy back in here at the 20 weekly moving average at 44k. In my opinion it's not worth the risk. It's only good if here we would have a big pump towards 100k or maybe even 200k, something like this, and then I would say okay, let's take some profits because we could crash down to the 20 weekly moving average to 44k, and then in my opinion it would be a good chance to take a bit of profits to then hopefully buy in cheaper. But here at 60k, in my opinion, we are still a bit too early. Of course we could have a bigger correction even down towards the 200 daily moving average, which currently is at around 24k. But overall, Bitcoin will go to way higher levels, my friends. So if something like this is happening, then just buy more, because like that, also your average price entry will be lower. So I wouldn't freak out right now just because of that. If a correction is happening, then just buy more with fresh fiat, because for the long term, we are anyway going higher. And that's why I want today to recap the stock to flow model price levels. And before we go there, we just gonna have a look here into the lower time frames because we are still in this potentially rising wedge here. I mean, if here we're gonna break out to the upside, then of course we're also gonna break out towards new all-time highs because we have now the 62K as the main resistance. But I still think that there could be a chance that maybe we're gonna see one more last leg down here to retest 58K and then gear up for a big breakout to the upside. But if here we are able to go above 62K, then I think we are good to go towards new all-time highs. And if you want to trade with the safe way, then wait until we broke 62K and also create a support above. So then we have to go and check the lower time frames like the 1 hour or 3 hour time frame. If here we are getting some closes above 62K, then we are confirming this as a new support and we should head towards our next target, which is up here at around 74K, our previous trend line here that acted as a support and now it could be acting as a resistance at least for the next big step. Because if we are able also to break here above 75K, then we could go to the next level up here at around 84K. And if this one is also broken, then I think we're gonna go straight towards 100K, potentially even a bit overshoot it as well to the upside. And then maybe we could get a correction, but only if somewhere we get some kind of a blow off top, then yes, we could be in here for a bigger correction. But if Bitcoin is able to go higher here and start to consolidate step by step towards new all-time highs here, then I think we might not get such a big correction right now and we just will head higher and higher until we're gonna reach our real cycle top for this bull market. So let's wait and see what will happen. For now, we are still below 62K. We still need to wait what will happen. And since we are a bit overbought here in the lower time frames, I can imagine that maybe here we're gonna have first a breakout to the downside to maybe retest this 58K where also the 200 moving average is lining up in the 4 hour time frame. But as soon as here we are breaking the 62K, we should be good to go to the upside. And we are back in an uptrend in the 4 hour, in the 3 hour, and also in the 1 hour time frame. So the lower time frames are suggesting that we will continue to go higher and potentially break 62K. Even here in the daily, we are looking extremely bullish. We are trading above all the important moving averages. And here the 9 daily moving average is exactly lining up at $58,600. So if we are having here a little breakout to the downside, then just watch for the 9 daily and 20 daily moving average. So let's say at around 58K, if here we are getting supported and if today we're gonna close above the 9 daily moving average, then we should be good to go here to the upside and hopefully have a breakout very, very soon towards new all-time highs. So the daily time frame also is looking extremely bullish. This ascending triangle could break out to the upside at any time now. And also if we update now the weekly time frame, you can see that currently we are still in this ascending triangle and we have to break out here to the upside or to the downside within this week, latest next week. So next week will be the last week that we could in theory be within this ascending triangle. And that's why, my friends, we are coming here to the end of this ascending triangle where we should see here a breakout, hopefully to the upside. But of course, if we would lose here the main support currently at 58K, we could also see a bigger correction first down to the 20 weekly moving average right here at 44K before maybe then we gear up towards new all-time highs and towards 100K. But since all-time frames are looking extremely bullish and this is also a bullish pattern, I'm still leaning more to the bullish side and I'm not taking profits here. I'm just gonna wait what will happen once we're gonna break out here to the upside, because I think the big parabolic move still need to come here to at least go towards 100K if we are able to take out these resistances above of us. And another bullish thing, of course, here in the weekly is also that we have now confirmed this bullish cross in the stochastic RSI. As you can see with last week's close, we now have this bullish cross confirmed. And usually whenever this happened in the past, we have seen always Bitcoin going completely parabolic to the upside. And I think this is also something that could happen here in the next coming days and weeks, especially if here we are able to break above 62. Okay, so now my friends, we can go over to the stock to flow model price because I want to show you why those purple lines that you can see here are very much relevant, not only for this cycle, but they also used to be very important for the last cycles. So this blue line that you can see here is the stock to flow model price. So let's make it in white so you can see it better. So what you can see here is the stock to flow model price after the halving of Bitcoin. And before we're gonna analyze this data with the actual price action, let's go back in the past. So let's go back in 2012, right before the halving that led into the bull market of 2013. So in 2012, we had this first halving. And as you can see, the stock to flow model price went straight up here to this first price level here at around $300. And I always have drawn these purple lines where we had a lot of confluence here with the stock to flow model price. So wherever we had a bounce or a rejection, I have drawn these purple lines. And as you can see in the future, those were quite relevant for the price action, because as you can see here with this first cycle that we had here with this parabolic pump of this bull market in 2013, this brought us very close to this $300. It stopped here at exactly $270, and then we had here a massive drop which brought us even below the first purple line here of $140. But this was not the cycle top of this bull run. Afterwards, we immediately recovered and then started this parabolic rise up towards $1,200. So this was almost a 4x from the stock to flow model price level that was predicting here the top at around $300. So the cycle top was about 4x from the stock to flow model price level. And afterwards, you can see that those three purple lines were very significant for the next bear market, because as you can see, Bitcoin then came always back down very close to the $300 level and always had some bounces here until then we crashed below, and then we went straight down to the second purple line here at $215. And as you can see here also, we always bounced from this important purple line, and we had then this $300 purple line as a resistance. So basically every time you bought here at this middle line or here towards the last purple line at around $140, you should have accumulated a lot of Bitcoin almost at the bottom here. So this was a perfect buy opportunity down at those lines during these bear market. And as you can see, as soon as we broke again above $300, Bitcoin never came below again, and we stayed here above the $300 purple line. And then of course after the next halving, we started our next bull run towards 20k. And here again, I have drawn here three purple lines, one here at the top of the stock to flow model price, which was at $6,400, and the bottom at around $4,400. So based on the stock to flow model price level, we should have gone here towards $6,200 from the actual price action that we had at that time, which was at around $650. So this was almost a 10x from the actual price action that we had here in 2016. So afterwards we started here this parabolic move towards those targets, and I still think that we are somewhere around here where we had initially some problems to go above this purple line. We had a bigger rejection, but afterwards we immediately recovered and then broke to the upside, and this is when we had this parabolic move towards 20k. So from the stock to flow model price top of $6,200, this was almost a 3x. And after this top, you can see that we came back down and always bounced nicely here at the $6,200 level. Bitcoin during this bear market always bounced here at around 6K, right where the stock to flow model price was predicting the top, or where Bitcoin should be trading at. So you see that also this top here from the stock to flow model price level was very accurate for the next bear market, because we always bounced at this important price level and every time we dropped below. So when we had here this crash down from $6,400 to around $3,000, so below this purple line, this signaled always the bottom and also a very good buy opportunity. And as soon as we recovered again above those important levels, Bitcoin stayed above and also bounced a couple of times again here at around 6K. Then of course we had this Corona dump, but afterwards we also immediately recovered back up. And also with this dump, you can see that we just came down to the first purple line and then immediately recovered back up. And then we had our recent halving here in May 2020. And here I did exactly the same thing. I have drawn here two purple lines. The one here is the top, right at $117,000, and right here at the bottom of around $62,000, exactly where we are at right now. So that's why these two price levels are, in my opinion, very important also for these next upcoming pumps and of course parabolic run up, and even for the next potential bear market. So based on the stock to flow model price, the 62K area for the next bear market will be a good buy opportunity and most likely the bottom of the next bear market. So that means that we are still far away from a cycle top, my friends, and we should expect the price to go at least up here towards $117,000, most likely also overshoot it, let's say by 2x, which would bring us towards $240,000. So if we only would do a 2x, not a 4x like last times, only a 2x from the top of this stock to flow model price level, this would bring us towards 240k before we could enter into a bear market where the bottom could be somewhere here at around 60k. So that's why I wanted to make a recap of those purple lines here, because I think those are going to be very, very much important here to predict the potential next cycle top and also where we're gonna see potentially a bottom in the next bear market. So that's why, my friends, selling now at this stage here, in my opinion, is too early. Even though we could even crash down to 40 or 30K, it's not worth the risk because we are right here at the bottom where most likely we're gonna be in the next bear market. So that's why if a crash is happening, buy more, but otherwise just hodl through and wait until we are going really completely parabolic, at least above $117,000. So let me know in the comment section, my friends, what do you think about this price prediction and also about this theory. I'm very interested about your thoughts. In my opinion, this is a very realistic theory what could happen here in the next coming weeks and months and where Bitcoin could be headed to next. So now that we have covered Bitcoin, let's go also over to Ethereum, because Ethereum is also looking extremely bullish right now. We are still below our price target here of around $2,500. And we are still below our resistance here of around $2,200. We are in this broadening wedge, but this could also end up in an ascending triangle, similar like over on a Bitcoin. And if here we're gonna have a breakout to the upside, I think we will go straight towards our target of around $2,500, maybe even overshoot it. So currently here, the lower time frames are looking extremely good, and I'm expecting here very, very soon a breakout to the upside. But if here we're gonna go below $2,100, then be prepared that first maybe we are coming down to test here the $1,900 area before then we gear up for a breakout to the upside. So the lower time frames right now are suggesting that we are going to see very, very soon in the next coming hours a breakout to the upside. But if we're gonna lose $2,100, then watch out here, because we could even go down here to test $1,900, and then here I'm expecting a bounce again to the upside. So if you're looking for a good long opportunity and long entry, then wait until $1,900. Otherwise, just open a trade after we're gonna break out here to the upside above $2,200, and then also in the lower time frames are starting to consolidate here. So this is how I would trade Ethereum for now. And also if we have a look here into the daily time frame, you can see that we are above all the important moving averages, and the 9 daily is right here at $2,100. So that's why it is important that we're not falling below this moving average, because otherwise we could easily come down here to test $1,900, also where more or less the 20 daily moving average is lining up. So also on Ethereum, everything is looking like that we're gonna see here a breakout to the upside. I think one or the other, Bitcoin or Ethereum, will start to lead here into the next big move. So let's wait and see which one is gonna move first, Bitcoin or Ethereum. And why I'm also still very bullish for a breakout to the upside without maybe even getting here another leg down to the downside for Bitcoin and Ethereum is also because the DXY is still falling. And as you can see, we had now two closes below the 200 daily moving average and even below the 20 and 9 daily moving average. So here we could easily now fall at least down towards the 50 daily moving average at $91.50. And that of course will lead into a potential big pump in the crypto and stock market. So the DXY continues to fall, and right now we are closing daily candles below those important moving averages. And if we are still in this ascending broadening wedge, which usually is a bearish pattern, then we even could drop here down towards $90. And if this support is getting lost, we're gonna see here a big waterfall to the downside in the DXY, and that of course would be very much in favor for the crypto and stock market. So the DXY is again starting to look a bit weak, but of course we are not out of the woods yet. We could still recover here in the DXY as soon as we are getting another buy signal, because money flow is still positive and also the RSI is right at the 50 level. So if here we are starting to drop below the 50 level in the RSI and also money flow is turning back into negative, then I think we have very good chances that here we could fall straight down towards $90 and then potentially even break out to the downside here. And that would be a big catastrophe for the US dollar index, but of course very much in favor for almost all other assets. And one asset that is in particular very bullish in my opinion is here Nasdaq, because also here we are coming very close to the all-time high here of around $14,000. And if we are able to break out here to the upside from this potential double bottom formation here, then we could easily reach, let's do here a conservative price target measurement, because if we would break out this week, then we could reach easily here $15,000. So if we are able to break above this all-time high that we had of $14,000, we could really go fast towards $15,000. And then of course, if we are able to consolidate at those region, then create this 14K as a new support and then move on towards new levels also here for Nasdaq. The only problem is that currently we are a bit exhausted here in the daily time frame. So the important thing is that we're gonna see here a breakout to the upside above 14K. Because if we are getting rejected here again, we could create here an ugly double top pattern, so a M pattern, and that of course is quite bearish, and that could lead into a massive correction here in Nasdaq. So important is that in here in the next coming days and weeks, we're gonna go above 14K, because that will deny this dangerous double top formation. But we are right at the edge here, my friends. We should expect also here a big pump incoming pretty soon. So with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. If you like the content, make sure to hit that like button and also subscribe to the channel. I do daily TA videos, and a big shout out to our great crypto trading chat over on Discord. If you want to join our crypto trading chat, then make sure to use the official link that you find down below here in the video description. Just click on this link and then go here to read first and click on this thumbs up button. Like this, you're confirming that you're a human and not a bot. And like this, you have free access to the trading chat. And if you also want to get access to my own indicator, which is giving you buy and sell signals for Bitcoin, then make sure to send me here a private message to get access to it, because a small donation is needed. Otherwise, just get a YouTube membership directly here. Like this, you also have free access to the trading chat indicator. And also check out all my referral links down below here if you need an account over on Bybit, Femex, Primex, BT, Binance, and so on, because with my links to the recommended exchanges that I'm also using are giving you some extra bonus, and of course you also support the channel. Especially if you are new and you need an account over on Binance or Coinbase, those links down below here will give you some extra money with your first purchase. So thank you again very much for watching, my friends, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.